Welcome to the Lighthouse. I'm so glad that you're here. Thank you for making time to tune in this medicine way. Let's start by closing the eyes and coming into the breath, as we always do, and recognizing that, you know, we've all been traveling our whole lives. We've been traveling our whole lives to get to this moment. So give yourself permission to check the stone suitcases at the bag, or at the door rather. Check your bags at the door and check in with your breath so that you can use these next many moments together of meditative work to come to truth and to align with perhaps one of the purest forms of intelligence, which is understanding your own energetic frequency and how it is impacting the world. Understanding your own energetic frequency and how it is impacting the world. So let us take this first moment to settle into the reality of what is, into the realness of it, into the rawness of it, and into the warmth that is beginning to stir in the freedom furnace in the ball of the belly. You know, we all, if we're here, so you all have some burning, growing fire of longing for freedom. And it starts as a little bit of an urge, which then can transform into an urgency, which can then transform into a kind of feeling of emergency, like I need to be in my wakefulness right now. And this moment can be our moment. This moment can be our moment, so that the practice of being alive can inspire us in such a way that we're actually doing our dharma, our unique individuated dharma, like our hair is on fire. So we want to let this kind of felt sense of emergency, the power of now that we feel stirring in the substratum of our being, we want to allow it to drive us towards grace, to allow us to say yes, to know that this moment can be our moment. And in allowing this moment to be our moment, the I can disappear. The I and the me and the mine can disappear, so that we really are in the power of a fresh mind, so that we really are in the power of this moment here, which is so young and so fresh that it cannot even belong to time. It is so fresh. And this orientation towards now is not an anxious orientation, but it's an opening up so that we can move through the personality door and move out into infinite space, into the realization that we belong to eternity. And this becomes available for us when we can come home into the essence nature. We don't have to be lifelong seekers. And something beautiful happens when we practice together in a group, you know, and obviously we're remote in this particular group, but we're all participating. Our energetic frequency is adding in, opting in to the alchemy of this collective. And the transformation exponentiates when we're in a group situation. So take this moment here to tune into the power of this particular group and recognize that when you're working with a group, you're also working with yourself, and you're doing that, you're helping to change the world by doing the inner work on your own heart. The practice awakens an existential eros within each of us to go on as the blossom and to not go back into the bud, so that we can identify when we're feeling helpless and use that tremendous amount of energy that is that feeling state of being helpless, and we can toggle into being helpers. When we feel that we've gone fetal around something or a situation, we can go from feeling fetal to moving that energy towards the front lines of generating change. we can move from just paying lip service to actually doing the truth service on the front lines of the work in our lives. And we can then, you know, have the wherewithal, we can have the reserve of life force within us to transform the drama. And we know that the drama is going to show up. It's just the law of existence, right? We can transform the drama into dharma, and we titrate it breath by breath, day by day. We titrate the practice, we titrate the process until it becomes more and more of who we are at an essential level. So that when you walk into a room, you are deeply attuned with your essence nature, less with the personality, less with, you know, the perceptual framework of what you think you aren't or what you think you can't do. You are attuned to the fact that you are part of the ecosystem of the space you just entered, and that you are part of the ecosystem of eternity, and you are able to give instead of showing up to look for what you can take. You can deliver a parenting warmth in whatever room you walk into, and help to hold and make safe in this exploding world, no matter the matter. These kinds of articulations that I've just spoken to, this is what it means, friends, to be a lighthouse. Every time we meet in this virtual way, we're streaming out of the lighthouse studio. That's why this place is called what it's called. That's what it means to be a lighthouse. Feel the instinctual effulgence of your own awareness that doesn't come and that doesn't go. Your awareness is not waning and waxing like the moon. I'm sorry for that abrupt stop in the music there. I am going to DJ though before we move into this awesome energy reboot practice that we're going to start with. It's kind of been like a lot of yin, slow, rainy energy, at least in this part of the world. So this is an incredible practice that we're going to start with. When you're doing this practice, be aware of the fact that you've got 84 facets in your mind. And each one of those facets in your human mind is a room with a view. If we let it be, right? And very oftentimes we're not allowing for that because whatever reason, our biology is out of balance, fear is on overdrive, or you know, maybe just the neural networks have just been firing and wiring in a not so healthy trajectory. So we've got 84 facets in the mind, each of which are a room with a view. We've got 84 power points throughout the whole body. So that means that your whole body is a kaleidoscope of possibility. You've got 84 meridians in the roof of your mouth. That's getting activated every time you speak. And that's why the power of word is so significant. And each one of these meridians in the roof of the mouth are gates to your human divine potential. And then every single one of the 27 vertebrae in your spine are like, each one of those bones is like a wisdom school waiting to be opened up like a file and activated so that it can, you know, pour open and spill forth and inform you at the level of knowledge, will, and action, and inform your every attitude, and inform the way that you are good in your skin. So this is an energy reboot. Let me turn on some beautiful music. Very beautiful music. So this is what it looks like. You're going to take a double inhale, and then inhale, and you're going to inhale through the nose, so it'll be out. And then you're going to make fists, and you'll double exhale with a kind of whistling breath, which is what it sort of sounds like when the condors are flying way above the mountain range. So it's... So at the peak of that second in-breath, my arms are behind my head and shoulders, and my head is hanging back, okay? My heart is then thereby lifting to the sky, and I'm stimulating and activating and opening up all of these meridians, all of these power points, and opening up every single one of those rooms with a view inside of the mind. So let's do this for a few minutes together. As the arms come in on the exhalation and with the whistle, contract, ring out your lung meridian. Ring out any of the sorrow or any of the melancholia that's stuck in the vessel of the heart and in the vessels of the lungs. By the caliber of the experiences that you allow yourself into. Go as deep into the medicine of the movement as you are willing and wanting to. Music from all different kinds of sources here, so I'm actively DJing. Here we go. So kind of staying in this reboot modality that's very young, very, very young, where you are, you know, you're reclaiming your instincts, you're reclaiming your natural wildness. So this is a beautiful, also a very beautiful practice. I love the practice that we were just in, and if you feel like you had a resonance with it, it's a fantastic practice when you're falling out of your own pocket, maybe you feel like you're, you know, losing it in whatever way, or maybe the melancholia or the overwhelm is so dense and so sticky, you don't know how you're gonna transform that vibe. Do that practice that we just did, this energy reboot practice, do it for 20 minutes and you'll move everything. You'll find yourself in a room with a view, I promise. This stuff works. So you're gonna press your thumb into the pad that's at the very base of your pinky fingers, and then you're gonna seal the other four fingers together and make a plate like I'm demonstrating here. So I'm gonna tap one elbow into the side of the rib as I shoot the other arm up on a diagonal. So with my left elbow plugged in at the rib, I'm gonna look to the left, and then I'm gonna alternate, looking to the right as the right elbow taps. And you wanna tap as if you're trying to crack the shell, okay, which you are cracking a shell. So tap and look. So you're gonna do it with a breath of fire. Something is poking me. So it's going to look like this. And I'm looking through 1/10 of an opening in the eyes. I'm looking through that little slot of an opening at the tip of the nose while I'm oscillating my head side to side. Okay, so keep your spine upright and bring all of your enthusiasm into the power of this practice. Enthusiasm is common, but endurance is rare. So bring your enthusiasm and let your enthusiasm help to fuel you when your mind says, oh, I'm done. So let's check this out. Plug the thumbs into the base of the small fingers. Seal the index, middle ring, and small fingers together, making a plate. Plug the left elbow into the side body, look to the left. And then right elbow into the side body, look to the right. Good. Stay with it. Joy body. Anything that has been stationing you and shoring you up in your pain body, use the potency of this kriya to get through it. To a close. So many magnificent small neuro movements going on in the completion energy of what we were just inside of. These neural movements and these large external muscular movements are optimizing your brain, potentiating your brain so that it can do for you what it was created to do for you, which is to be an intrepid learner. you know, and to do what it was doing for you when you were, you know, a tiny little vibrant child who was maybe not such an adult collector of the traumas that we tend to collect. You know, and when a child is in a learning mode, it can make up to 1 million neuro connections a second, which means that like in a 3, 4, 5, 7, 22, 32, 62 minute kriya of doing something like this, that you're making billions and billions and billions of new connections, which is really good news. And you're also simultaneously developing your inclination towards restoration. Chances are good. You feel vibrant, you feel alive, right? And it's this aliveness that allows us to have a little bit less fear around the unknown and to recognize that through the meditative mind, what is unknown becomes known. I find that to be an incredibly fascinating, unique osmosis that goes on when we're practicing. So we are going to, I'm going to actually just turn this super cool song all the way down. So we are going to plug our thumbs into the soft part of the pad of the thumb into the temple, and then lift your elbows up to the level of the shoulders. And then tuck the chin in towards the pit of the throat. And then you're gonna squeeze your back molars together. Something amazing happens in the master glands of the brain when you squeeze your back molars together. In this case, you're doing it in a mindful manner. Something happens, right? When you're stressed out or you're worried or you're anxious about whatever, a lot of us human beings clench our jaw together. I mean, it's just commonplace. But it's the intelligence of the human organism trying to create a readjustment. So something happens, a reconfiguration, a rebalancing, a stimulation of those master glands happens when you squeeze the back molars. So you're gonna squeeze the back molars, and this is a meditation practice for overcoming any kind of addiction. And you know, we don't have to be addicted to something like rage or cigarettes in order to be in order to have addiction issues. All of us are addicted to our own unique brand of specialized concepts that we think are the reality of what is, when in fact they're just part of some dream up there in the brain, in the mind, right? So what, you know, and perhaps what emotion might you be addicted to? And we become not just addicted to the expression and the experience of the emotion, but we also become addicted to the corresponding chemical that then surges through the body when we're experiencing that emotion that is commonplace. So if you feel like it's easy for you to go into melancholia, you're probably addicted to those chemicals that your body is getting a hit of when you're feeling bluesy, right? So these are such incredible ways to become a much more sovereign designer of the future, because you are becoming a better driver in the vehicle of your being. So we're gonna work with, I'm just gonna keep that stereo turned down so that we can work with a mantra of sa, ta, na, ma. But you're gonna sound it on the inside of your body so that you can keep the jaw clenched. So you're gonna say it on the inside of the body in the quiet space of your mind. I'm actually going to articulate it verbally so that you have something to kind of rhythmically follow along with. And so think of what that specialized concept is that you might be tethered to, that is perhaps showing up in the field as a behavioral addiction, as a mental addiction, as an emotional addiction, and let it find its freedom. Let this be your moment. So, sa, ta, na ma. Now every time you hear me say those mantras of sa ta na ma, pull your abdominal wall back on each of those sound currents. So sa ta na ma, sa ta na ma. Still clenching the jaw. Sa ta na ma, sa ta na ma. Looking at the tip of the nose. Sa ta na ma, 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 sa ta na ma. Take a couple more. Holding in your auric field that you can be in the power of this moment, in the freshness of a clear mind, resting in the awareness which neither comes or goes, or is arising or falling, or appearing or disappearing, resting in awareness which is always here for each of us. We just simply stop being aware that we are aware, but resting in that awareness, and resting in infinite space. Ah. None of us has a perfect recipe, and that too is something to take refuge in. So we want to, you know, follow our particular truths when we're practicing, and come to truth like we're putting our head in that tiger's mouth, so that it can consume all of our specialized concepts, and so that we can allow the passing of the clouds in the mind and feel, you know, our radiant, primordial, empty nature. Our emptiness is our true natural state. And there is nothing that we could add that would make us more than what we already are. So let's move right along. Let me just turn some beautiful music on. So you're going to join the middle ring and small fingers with the tip of the thumb so that you can use your index fingers like conductors. And you're going to bring the fingers in while you hang the head back, and then look forward as you open the arms up. So inhale and exhale. Close down the eyes, 9/10 of the way, so that you're looking through that 1/10 of a sliver down at the base, and the gaze is set at the tip of the nose. Allow yourself to be here now in your body, in the practice, in this moment, here now in such a way. Look at this moment from the inside of your inside in such a way that you are confirmed of your completeness here now. break the practice at the end of that second one and come into the feeling that's in your gut. Gut feelings are guardian angels. So follow your gut. The head doesn't know, the heart knows. If the heart doesn't know, the gut always knows. So tune in this moment. And when we listen in that kind of way, then we can use our practice every single time to help leverage our legacy, to take the reins on our own wellness, and to build, to actively create a life of thriving that is aligned with the meaning and purpose that we feel most connected with on our journey right now. So we're going to use the tips of the fingers to seal off many of the gates in the face, okay? Not only are we sealing the gates in the face, but then we're going to use sound. And it's a particular sound that's called Brahmari, which sounds like a bee. So your whole head is going to become the hive. So it's not just one bee, but many. And you're going to explore the sound in a really subtle, sophisticated, sublime way. You're sending the sound, you're pulling the sound up from the nod of the belly, and you're sending it through the nasal conch, which is right here where the nose joins in with the portal to the brain. And then you're letting the sound really get in there like a roto-rooter in the mind, okay? So this is what the fingers are going to do. I'm going to show you the placement for the fingers, and then I'm going to demonstrate what the sound is going to look like. And then we're going to do it together 9 times, okay? So I'm going to demonstrate 1 sound current cycle with the Brahmari so you can hear and get a sense of where we're headed. So have a peek, but don't follow just yet. I'll re-articulate, but this is what it looks like. So the small fingers below the bottom lip, ring fingers above the top lip, middle fingers to the bridge of the nose, index fingers to the tear ducts, and the thumbs are going to seal the little tab of the ears into the opening of the ears. So now you've really gotten into an aquatic sounding internal space, or into the hive, if you will. So I'm going to inhale through the nose, and then on the exhale through the nose, I'm going to send the sound. I'm going to send the breath out and the sound up into the chamber of the skull. Now at the completion of the out breath, I'm not grabbing another inhale. I'm going to squeeze at the perineum, and I'm going to lift the energy from the perineum up into the ball of the belly, and I'm going to pull it back then to the spine, up through the gate of the diaphragm, into the cave of the heart, through the transit of the throat, through the void space of the open mouth, of the openness inside of the mouth, and up into the crown of the head. Okay, so that's one cycle. Once you do that abdominal upward lifting lock, then you'll relax the abs and source your next in-breath. So by the time you've done this 9 times, you have completely transformed your lead into gold, promise. So let's do this. Bring the small fingers below the bottom lip, ring fingers above the top lip, and press just gently. So we're activating all the nadis and the meridians, which are very easy to find because they're right there, actively participating just under the surface of the skin where all the amrita is flowing, all that honey. So you're getting into the hive and creating delicious medicinal iteration of honey. Index fingers into the tear ducts. Gently, gently place them there. You don't need to press. You don't want to overstimulate the eye or the eye socket. Press the thumb into the ear and then 9 rounds. Inhale. Lifting the root to the belly, to the heart, to the head, to the infinite. and relax the abs and source the next breath. So on your own, take the next 8. Gifts of this practice, Sun Mukhi Mudra, is that it aligns us with our subtle body wisdom, the sort of synovial intelligence that's flowing through our liquid nature. And life is sometimes so subtle, turning that up instead of down. Life is sometimes so subtle that we don't even notice ourselves walking through the doorways that we were previously praying to have. So with practices like this today, you know, we can attune ourselves with our subtle beingness so that we have fresh eyes to see all of those new openings that are constantly presenting themselves, so that we can notice all of the small nuances, you know, and it's the small habits, it's how you spend your morning, how you talk to yourself, what you're reading, what you're watching, who you share your energy with, who has access to you. All of these small details are what change us in those gradual, subtle, evolutional ways. self inside of the self, the you within you that you came here to be. So allow yourself, if you're not already, to sit and kind of marinate, let your mind marinate in the clarity of all the practices that we presenced with today. You know, every time we practice, it adds positive energy to the organism. It adds positive energy to your mind. The subconscious mind is going to add its own resistance and reactivity and potential chaos. And we can expect that. But the practices always add positive energy so that we can have a greater sense of clarity and a more elevated caliber in our knowledge and in our will and in our action and in our capacity to simply be, and to also know that those moments of radiant beingness, they too are impermanent. The clouds are going to show back up, and those clouds are also impermanent. And we're constantly on the road. We're on the road. So that means that each of us are like some kind of fancy sports car. And the unfortunate part of that realization is that a lot of us are just utilizing maybe two or three of the controls inside of the fancy sports car while we're tearing down the highway of our own, life, of our own becoming. But the technologies of the practice empower you. They give you the skills to use absolutely all of the controls inside of the sports car that is the vehicle of you, so you can enjoy the trip. You're welcome. So just take this moment, let this moment can be your moment. We don't have to be lifelong seekers. Let yourself marinate in the glory and the grandeur and the fullness and the totality and the deliciousness of right here, right now. And it can happen at once if we're not too tethered. Tethered too tightly to all of our specialized concepts. Just breathing. Like I was saying at the very beginning of our session today, that one of the purest forms of intelligence is to understand our own energetic frequency and how it's affecting the world. And that's one of the beautiful things that I always carry forward from my practice every single time. Sure that I'm not contributing to the chaos, but that I'm at least positioned a little bit more steadily to be the lighthouse, to walk into the room attuned, to recognize myself as part of the ecosystem, to bring my parenting warmth. You know, when I talk about a parenting warmth, it has nothing to do with your biological status of having a child or not having a child. It is a mode of consciousness, right? To bring your parenting warmth so that you can help and hold and heal in a world that needs so much of that right now. So how can we use all of the breakthroughs in today's session to more actively align with our future affinities that are calling to us, that are courting us from, the adventure horizon, that are beckoning to us from the formless? How can we use all of the shapes that we make when we practice to get a little bit closer to our shapelessness, to move across the threshold into infinite space, into the sustainable intelligence of our perennial wisdom that is within? That you took this time to be here today. And may you go in peace, may you go in strength, and may you go completely full of the awareness of joy. Joy being your essential nature. Thank you so much. I'll see you very soon.